This is the Whistler Black Home, home to the mountain bike park. It is the premier lift access downhill bike park in the world with 4,900 vertical feet of descending trails that includes miles and miles of the very best natural terrain in North America, if not the entire planet. At the base, where the village meets the mountain, is a course unrivaled in its scale and size, flanked by 30,000 rampant fans who are here to behold the world's top riders dropping into the best slopestyle event on the planet. This is Joyride at Crankworx Whistler, and you are watching the Red Bull Signature Series. Hey everybody, Sal Masekela here, your host of the Red Bull Signature Series, and allow me to welcome you to the mountain paradise that is just north of Vancouver, British Columbia, Canada. This is Whistler Mountain Resort. If you're looking for a winter, summer playground, this is it, home to the world-class skiing and snowboarding in the winter, and in the summer, one of the premier mountain bike parks in the world. Today though, it's not all about fun, as we're turning our attention to the top slopestyle mountain bikers on the planet, taking on the toughest course on the Crankworx World Tour. Three stops, starting in Rotorua, New Zealand, then traveling to Leguettes, France, and wrapping up things here in its home base, Whistler, British Columbia. This year, the riders face a massive course with a record 14 jumps and features, making Joyride the biggest competition of the entire tour. The favorite? Well, that has to be the hometown hero, a record four-time winner, the dominator, Brandon Semenuk. He denied fellow countryman Brett Rheeder on his quest to be the first ever to win the Triple Crown last year. However, you also have to watch out for the international contenders, including the previous winner, Thomas Chenon of Belgium, and a Swedish contingent that are looking to make their mark in this event. We're all set for the final, so we're gonna check in with Todd Harris and Cam McCall.
Thank you, Sal. Well, Cam, this really is the biggest event in slopestyle mountain biking.
You're right. It's the pinnacle of the sport. It's what everybody trains for all year round. And everybody's trying to stay healthy through all the other events and drop their bangers here. Something different about the course this year, it's the longest course in the history of the sport. So stamina is going to be the name of the game out here.
All right, you talked about staying healthy. What is it going to take to get a full pole here in Whistler?
You know, it's going to take some endurance, actually. 14 features, all of which you have to do banger tricks on. The sport has progressed to the point where you can't have filler tricks anymore. So expect to see these guys really going for broke and huffing and puffing at the bottom of this course.
And here's how it works at Joyride at Crankworx. Best of two runs. Now the second run start order is restacked in reverse order based on run one scores, and they are scored out of 100. And Cam, the most important thing is, what are the judges looking for?
The judges are looking for six specific criteria. First one being amplitude, basically how high the rider is above the lip. There's some steep lips out there, so expect to see some boost. Degree of difficulty, pretty self-explanatory, how tough the tricks are they choose to do. And variety, there's 14 trickable features on this course, so you can't repeat the same trick all the way down. You gotta have a well-rounded run. Execution, everything from extension to smooth landings, judges are looking for that. And course use, if you do a difficult trick on a difficult feature, that's gonna get a big score. And of course, the biggest contest of the year, the judges are looking to see risk-taking. You gotta put it all on the line out here at Joyride.
Once again, a massive crowd has turned out to see the world's best compete on one of the most technical courses you will see year-round. And we have amassed the top athletes in the world who have made the trek to North America here in British Columbia to see who has the best tricks, as Cam just pointed out. Before we get things started, we want to check in with the fourth member of our broadcast team for a little more on what we should expect today in Canada as the world's best is combined. Here is Tina Dixon.
Todd, I'm down here watching practice, and I almost feel like I'm studying for a math class, trying to figure out all these new combinations these riders are doing and potential value of their runs. Now, keep in mind, this is the biggest course we have seen here at Joyride, and it all finishes up with this massive flat drop. I haven't seen a lot of tricks being thrown down on that. The riders saving the best for the finals, knowing that that feature can actually make or break a rider's run. Now, what I did see in practice, though, was Brandon Semenuk clap when he saw Nikolai Rogatkin do one of his newer tricks, appreciating the difficulty of it. But guys, Brandon is the favorite. He is so clean. And if Nikolai Rogatkin wants to win, he has got to be absolutely perfect today.
All right, thank you, Tina. Much more from you a little later on as the competition gets going. But right now, let's check out the course preview.
Ryan Howard here, Justin Wiper, Dustin Gilding. This is your 2016 Red Bull Joyride course preview. Okay, we're starting her off with a nice little flat draw. Into the left berm, into the long and low step up here. Come around, nice flat turn into the first big flat drop. Nice roller, keep your speed. Big poppy jump. Nice left hip. Right into the flowy left-hand berm and into the first set of the four pack. One, two. Right into the right hip here. You gotta keep your speed, go into the whale tail. In, out. Rail the left-hand berm right into the cannon here. Nice and poppy. Into the setup for the last feature. On. Nice big flat drop off, keeping it old school. Boom.
And what stands out right off the bat is this is 14 features this year, Cam. They are not messing around.
Yeah, it's the longest course we've ever seen at Joyride, the longest course in the history of slopestyle, so it's kind of an endurance event this year.
Dropping first, Tomas Zeta out of the Czech Republic, the 26-year-old now on course.
Yeah, Tomas Zeta, basically a fixture on the FMB Diamond Series these days, a real tall, lengthy character, known for his big extension on his tricks, and very complex combination, starting things off with a 360 off that big drop into the steepest ramp on the course with a highly boosted backflip X-up. Now a 450 on that hip, spinning the direction of the hip, so having to over-rotate more than a 360. A backflip tail up, oh, landing a little bit sideways. Looks like he squirreled out, lost a little bit of speed. Oh, there's no air in that back tire. Todd blew the tire off the rim, landing sideways.
So Zeta with a great first half of the run. Unfortunately, it ends there.
Take a look at this backflip tail up. It's perfect in execution until the very last second. He lands slightly sideways, and that's a lot of pressure for that rubber to hold on to the rim. It blew out. Not gonna make it to the bottom of the course with no air in your tire.
So Zeta will have to look to his second and final run after he has that repair. The score coming down is a 22.8. We have a lot more action to come here, including this man, BMX veteran and mountain bike rookie Ryan Nyquist, when we return to Joyride at Crankworx Whistler. You're watching the Red Bull Signature Series.
With 16 X Games medals, 36 X Games competition starts, and 60 Du Tour finals appearances, you can say that Ryan Nyquist has nothing left to prove and is clearly one of the greatest and most decorated riders in the history of his sport. However, mountain biking, not his sport. Nyquist is a BMX rider and competitor, and despite being 37 years old, extremely relevant in the scene, constantly a top finisher against the kids. So it really should be no surprise that this modern journeyman has decided to start competing in mountain bike slopestyle and is proving that he has what it takes to be competitive.
Ryan Nyquist has been a professional BMX athlete for 20 years.
It'll be interesting to hear if anyone doesn't know who Ryan Nyquist is here. I mean, he's so legendary in BMX.
He's been like winning X Games since before I was born. Ryan
Nyquist! My first BMX was a Nyquist Pro. It's unbelievable to see this guy riding with us.
This is kind of my first year riding slopestyle. I won't say it's been easy. It's been really, really difficult, and I've had to work really hard to get to this point. Pretty darn excited about being here, to be honest. But I am also slightly nervous and scared because the course is probably the biggest course I've ever ridden.
A bike is a bike, and a trick is a trick. But slopestyle and BMX are like two different things.
I started riding mountain bikes a little over a year ago.
The bikes are just way bigger, generally heavier than a BMX, harder to maneuver.
For me, it kind of helps me with BMX as well, because I have to work so much harder to get the same tricks done on mountain bike. When I hop back on my BMX bike, it's like, oh, this is really easy now.
Still keeping his like BMX style, so he has some pegs on his bike. I feel like it's a good way to come to mountain bike, but still being like himself.
Nyquist comes in, starts a whole new sport at 37.
I'm pretty much hooked on mountain bike right now. I couldn't be more happy with the progress I've made, and just being here, it's a true dream.
So here he is, the 37-year-old rookie out of Santa Cruz, Ryan Nyquist. Cam, the guy is a legend, no question about it. But how will he transfer all that talent from BMX to Joyride?
Well, he's been working so hard, and you call him a rookie, it feels hilarious to call him a rookie, because he defines the word legend when it comes to jumping two wheels through the air. And to be able to work that hard and apply all of his skills to a bigger bike is truly impressive. Dropping in to his first appearance at Red Bull Joyride right now, huge overspin 720 on the hip, classic Ryan Nyquist style. And there we go, a backflip one-handed X up on the first jump on the four pack. There we go, getting good variety, doing a 360 one-handed X up. Whoa, that's an opposite rotating overspin 450 suicide no-hander. This is a classic Ryan Nyquist run right here. Only difference, he's on a mountain bike. 360 double bar spin. Oh, landing over rotated. And once again, another tire blowing off the rim, Todd.
So he comes off the whale tail and doesn't land it cleanly. And there's what happens. The bike takes the damage.
But always a showman. I can't explain to you at home, sitting back, this crowd is roaring for this man. Let's take a look back at what made this run special. The first half of it was flawless with that rocket suicide no-hander, putting his feet on the pegs, the only rider with pegs. That overspin 720, more like an 800-degree rotation. Then here we go, 360 double bar spin. Mm. Only a few degrees over-rotated, but that's a few degrees too much, and that back tire couldn't hold on.
And Ryan's ridden enough to know exactly that feeling when he came up and the back end is basically destroyed. So he'll go make the repairs. 34 really does him no good. Ryan Nyquist has one more run here at Joyride. As we go back to the top of the course, this will be Matt Jones out of Great Britain, just 22 years of age. At 22, he's 15 years younger than Ryan Nyquist. And this guy has more experience on the mountain bike than Nyquist, though.
They're in the same situation right now, competing in their first ever Joyride, but obviously in different stages of their career. Matt Jones climbing the ladder, making it to Joyride. Starting things off with a flat drop flip, getting his weight all the way behind the rear wheel. And once again, that's what it looks like getting your weight behind the bike when you have a huge steep lip, a double backflip. Then a 270 into the hip. Now he's into the four pack. A backflip tail whip, coming up a little tiny bit short, but still squeezing through and getting that nice 360. What's he got on the right hip? Oh, an overspin 720. Oh, too much rotation going down for Matt Jones. Wow, we saw him start this run out really strongly with this flat drop backflip. Notice there's no lip there, so he's got to basically do a wheelie off the end of that to initiate the flip. And watch him do that same body motion, but this time off the steepest lip on the course for a double flip. Absolutely going for the jugular right off the bat in this run. And then rotating twice, just on a different axis, this time a 720. He knew he had to over-rotate, but he rotated even too much for that hip. And once he spotted that landing, he knew it was too late to slow it down.
So Matt Jones up and moving around. Three riders have yet to finish this entire course, and he'll have one more run. Well, the course here at Whistler's proving to be the hardest yet. Will anyone be able to conquer it? We'll find out when we return to Joyride at Crankworx Whistler. You're watching the Red Bull Signature Series. Welcome back to beautiful British Columbia, Canada and the Red Bull Signature Series. This is Joyride at Crankworks Whistler. And our next rider is Anthony Missouri. But while we are away, Logan Peet, the 26-year-old Canadian, took to this course. And once again, Cam, no one's been able to pull a full pull on this thing. There's 14 features and it's really taking its toll.
It's crazy, actually. I mean, Logan Peet is a guy who's very known for his fluidity and consistency, and not even he could pull off an entire run top to bottom. Started out great with that backflip bar spin, but right here, this tail up, a very easy move for him and an uncharacteristic bail. Looked like his cranks moved. He wasn't able to get back on smooth, so he's gonna have to regroup, get back up there for run number two.
And a reminder, it is a two-run event, and we only keep your best score. So we're set to go now with another Canadian, Anthony Missouri, just 20 years of age. It seems like he's been around the sport for so long, still not even 21.
Absolutely. In front of his home crowd right here, and he has been around for a long time. He burst out onto the scene in 2011. So these fans love him, not only because he's a hometown hero, but because this is where he really cut his teeth and made a name for himself on the mountain bike circuit. Starting things off, tail open up that step up. Now we're gonna get serious now, dropping off the first big drop. A 360 bar spin, getting a great combination. Now off the steep jump, backflip bar spin, a tuck no hander with really good extension. And then there's that amplitude that we know Anthony Missouri for. Basically, his trademark criteria, the judges love his amplitude. A backflip tail up, looked like he slipped a little bit of a pedal, but still holding speed for that front flip. A double tail up on the hip. Todd, are we gonna see our first top to bottom here? This is looking good so far.
Up onto the whale tail.
A 360 up and a backflip bar spin down. Really tough combo to do on a step down. Oh, losing traction in the berm. He's absolutely roosting down this course. Well, one more big feature to go here. The final on off. Backflip up the step up. 18 feet drop, tail up to pedals. There we go.
So Anthony Missouri becomes the first man to get a full pull here at Joyride.
Now it's about time we saw somebody get top to bottom. I mean, tricking every feature with things like that backflip to tuck no hander, backflip bar spin to tuck no hander, and then this backflip tail up. I think he had a little tiny mistake there, slipped a pedal, and I'm really impressed with his ability to still get that front flip. A front flip is a trick where you actually need more speed than usual to clear the jump. That just shows how good he is at keeping his composure. And then finishing things off with this tail whip, it's a very difficult trick to do off of a tall drop like that, especially if there's any wind going on. So good job for Anthony Missouri.
And the score coming down for Anthony, remember, just 20 years of age, he's been on the podium twice before, an 81.60, so that becomes the mark to beat. Well, our next rider is one of the two young up-and-comers here from Sweden, and to learn more about this new Scandinavian contingent, let's send it over to Tina Dixon, who's standing by with the original Swede here at Joyride.
Yeah, I'm with a very familiar face, Martin Soderstrom, the other Swedish rider. Martin, what's your involvement in Emil's upbringing, getting back into the mountain biking scene?
Oh, first of all, I'm just so proud of that guy. And also Max Fredriksson, actually. They're both Swedish and super proud of them. But let's talk about Emil, yeah. I mean, last year, he didn't even have an F&B license. And this year, he's really proven himself. And I really think he's been doing it, like, the right way. He has just been practicing in Sweden in a cold indoor place and really showing the young riders that it's possible to grow up in Sweden and doesn't have the best setup and still make it to the biggest event of the year.
Well, let's see if that focus and motivation can pay off. Here's Emil.
All right, thank you, Tina, and nice to have Martin Soderstrom standing by as well. This is Emil Johansson, just 17 years of age, and he is now on course.
It's nuts. The amount of talent coming out of Sweden these days is absolutely off the wall. And this kid's 17, he's 20 years younger than Ryan Nykus, who we just saw drop into his first Joyride. But in his first season, stacking up enough results to make it here, I don't think I've ever seen that before. So starting things off with some great tricks. He had an opposite tail up at the start, that backflip bar spin, and now that opposite tail up on the hip, right into a backflip tail up and into the second jump. A 360 bar spin to inward table. Really unique, stylish trick there for Emil. And a double tail up on the hip. Man, he's looking so composed. This is not usually what you see out of a 17-year-old. Suicide no-hander up, backflip bar spin down. He does not have step-down features to practice at home in Sweden, so he basically uses practice here at the event to not only get ready for the event, but learn tricks on these unique features.
Last feature.
A double bar spin up, and a 360 down the drop. So impressive to see him at 17, 360 down 20-foot drops. That's definitely something usually reserved for the veterans.
On his first run, the 17-year-old goes top to bottom, all 14 features, and Cam, very clean.
Now that's an opposite tail up off the drop. He just learned how to tail up drops here at the beginning of the event. So a backflip bar spin, a 1 foot of can, but this was one of the highlights of the run for me right here. This is the embodiment of all six of the judges' criteria. Execution, extension, precision, a unique trick, that 360 bar spin to inward table, and look how straight he lands with that landing, eyeing up the next feature. Definitely a rider that, you know, could be around for a really, really long time if he continues on this path.
Emil Johansson looking for his score to come down on his first run of two, and it's a good one, 85.20, and Johansson goes into first. Amazing work by Emil. Can he hold on to that top spot? Plenty more top competitors to come, including four-time Joyride champion Brandon Semenuk. Or will it be the 2015 Crankworx Slopestyle overall winner, Brett Rheeder? Their turns when we return to Joyride at Crankworx Whistler. You're watching the Red Bull Signature Series.
Welcome back to the Red Bull Signature Series. I am your host, Sal Masekela, and this is Joyride at Crankworx Whistler. Brett Rheeder, this guy's name is always in the discussion when it comes to being the top rider in the discipline of slopestyle. It's usually associated with his arch rival and fellow countryman, Brandon Semenuk. Now these two always seem to be battling it out for the top of the podium. 2015, Brett dominated Crankworx Slopestyle, winning both events in New Zealand and France, and was poised to capture Slopestyle's first ever triple crown. The pressure though, too much. Brett was defeated not only by himself, but by an incredible performance from the hometown hero, Semenuk. But a year has passed, and Brett has grown stronger both physically and mentally, and he hopes to finally capture a win at the one event that has always eluded him, Joyride.
So here we go, Brett Rheeder.
I've never won Red Bull Joyride.
Brett Rheeder in second place.
I came second and fourth the year before, so I've been climbing the ladder, but from second to first is a whole nother level. Last year was the best year of my life and probably the worst year of my life.
Rheeder was on the pinnacle of his career and the best year he could ever have.
Pressure really now is on Brett Rheeder as he tries for the first triple crown to sweep the whole thing.
The media was like, Brett Rheeder this, Brett Rheeder that. You know, can you win it? Can you win it? Can you not do it?
Brett Rheeder, man, trying to get this triple crown, that's a lot of pressure.
And it was actually so much pressure that I got sick on the final day.
So the last man to drop in on run number one is Brett Rheeder.
Got a backflip double tail. Oh, wow.
It's so competitive now and it's gnarly. And I saw him land that flip double whip in practice numerous times. Perfect.
As Brett Rheeder gets set for run number two.
Now or never for Brett Rheeder. Here's where things went awry for Rheeder last run. The backflip double tail. Can he get it? He gets it. What's he got on the second? Oh, no.
That's competition. And it ain't easy. The stress will eat you alive.
Oh, and his hopes at the triple crown just came to a screeching halt.
There was way too much pressure. This year I've kind of stepped back a bit and kind of enjoying everything. I don't want to put too much pressure on myself, but I would really feel happy if I somehow got the win at Red Bull Joyride.
And there he is, Brett Rheeder, sitting atop the course, the 23-year-old originally from Mount Albert, Ontario, looking for the big win here at the Super Bowl for mountain bike slopestyle.
Well, he's in a good situation right now. Last year, the pressure on his shoulders was, you know, you heard Cam Zink say, pressure can bring you to your knees. And right now, he basically hasn't had an amazing season, but he's on an amazing riding level. He just had minor bobbles at other events leading into this. But right now, he's time to win the one event that he hasn't been able to win so far. A backflip bar spin, whoa, to opposite tail up. I've never seen him do a backflip bar spin to tail up. So bringing a new trick and doing it opposite right off the get-go. Into the four pack, the Cork 720. Can he link it on the second jump? He does the opposite Cork 720 and he lands it so smooth. The degree of difficulty and how well-rounded this run is so far with opposite variations of basically every trick he's done so far. Opposite tail up, backflip bar spin to tuck no-hander. Such a huge combo for a step down into the cannon log. A backflip tail whip. That is the first time that trick has ever been landed in slopestyle competition. Two more tricks left for Brett Rheeder.
Oh.
A front flip up, a backflip one-footed can off the flat drop. That was one of the best runs I've ever seen, Todd.
And what a moment for Brett Rheeder, pulling off one of the most technical runs we've ever seen at Joyride, and it's clean from top to bottom.
Well, let's look at all the little intricacies of this run. Now, this is a fast plant 360, but check it out. It's his opposite direction. Try to do your signature with your opposite hand. Good luck. Now, speaking of opposites, a backflip bar spin to opposite tail. A new trick for him, and he's already doing it opposite. Now here we go, on the same theme with these opposite tricks, a cork 720, huge move in the world of slopestyle. Nobody else is linking that right into an opposite cork 720. I feel like we're watching a snowboard contest right now. Now an opposite tail whip up the step up. Better get your feet on the pedals, because he's gonna do a backflip bar spin to tuck no hander. I mean, on a step down, that trick is so tech. Then now it makes sense why he did the opposite tail up in the flip up there, because he was planning on doing a backflip tail up his regular direction on the cannon. And like we said at the top of the show, you do tricks like that on a difficult feature like a cannon, and the judges just love it. Finishing things off smooth with the way he started his run last year, putting the icing on the cake. What a run, Todd.
Mark to beat is an 85.20 put up by Emil Johansson just moments ago. Remember, he's won pretty much every major slopestyle contest except this one, and that score will help. 93 for Brett Rheeder as he goes in to first place here on run number one, and he's now standing by with Tina Dixon.
That run was just jam-packed with difficulty. The 720 to the oppo 720. I mean, it was just one after another, and you did it all the way down to the bottom. How redeeming is it compared to what you did last year?
Yeah, I know. Last year I had two crashes like right in a row. So to be down here right now is pretty special. It's such a long course, two features longer than last year. And we really haven't even ridden to the bottom till this morning. So doing all the best tricks, or all my best tricks down to the bottom, it's tiring.
You know, I was watching you earlier in practice, and you have been so calm. Has there been pressure this year compared to last year?
Not as much. Like, we had the Triple Crown pressure last year. But this year, it's more just personal pressure. Like, I haven't done amazing. So, yeah, hopefully I can hold my score.
Well, what a way to start out. 93, guys.
Thank you, Tina. An incredible run for Rheeder, which puts him on top above Johansson in second and Missouri in third. But we're just getting into the top riders, like this man, Brandon Semenuk, who has stood on more than half the podiums here at Joyride since its inception 13 years ago. We'll have his run when we return to Joyride at Crankworx Whistler. You're watching the Red Bull Signature Series.
Welcome back to the Red Bull Signature Series. You are watching Joyride at Crankworx Whistler, and I am your host, Sal Masichella. What does it take to win at Joyride? Well, you need to have the talent and the skills to navigate what is, with over 14 features, the biggest course in the sport. No room for error, full commitment on each and every trick. However, it's also a mind game. It's one where you hold your cards really close and you plot each move as you keep an eye on your competitor and what they're gonna do. Only a handful of riders have ever won Joyride in its history, and all of them would like to stand on that podium again and bask in the glory of winning. The Crankworx slopestyle game has been around for 13 years. And as the tricks have evolved, so have the strategies.
Cam Zink, the 28-year-old from Reno, Nevada.
Back in the early days, when Cam Zink took two victories, the strategy was all or nothing. The tricks were so risky that you held your cards close to your chest and only tried them in your final run. You either won or you blew up trying. As the game evolved, so did the tricks. Greg Watts introduced combination tricks that took practice and preparation. The all-or-nothing attitude was too high stakes, and consistency became the new name of the game. But in any game, there is always an element of luck. And when paired with raw determination, the results can be spectacular.
Oh, nice!
You win again.
Oh, him or me?
You.
Oh, cool.
In 2011, the tables turned, and it became as much a game of skill as it did a game of strategy.
Brandon Semenuk, so many podiums.
A young rider came up through the ranks, taking all the talents that had brought his predecessor's victory and combined them all together. He had the consistency of Watts combined with the determination of Janai.
Too hard on the back end. Man, loop
out that tail whip. This is where it went wrong.
The final hit for Semenuk.
And he pulls it.
While still keeping his cards close to his chest and saving a couple all-or-nothing moments similar to Zink. But in a game where the odds are stacked against you and with Brandon already holding four victories, is it possible to achieve a fifth?
So the question for you, Cam, first of all, why weren't you at that table? And how have these guys been so dominant over the last 7-8 years?
Yeah, it's crazy. As the sport of slopestyle has evolved, the riders have had to do the same. And I love that feature comparing slopestyle to poker, because it is all about how much you're willing to put on the line. But, you know, you gotta be smart about it too and not put all your chips on the table, because, you know, you might just explode. And, you know, Brandon Semenuk, definitely a guy who understands the poker game of slopestyle. Well, where's Brandon?
Whoa.
Wow, I know he has something really big planned for this feature right here, but did he fall off the side of the bridge right there?
And Semenuk has gone off course.
You know what? He's running a free coaster hub on the rear wheel of his bike, and I know he's got some big tricks planned kind of to really enter a new chapter in slopestyle, but let's see what happened. Yeah, you can see right there, he completely slid out on the outside. He was trying to set up really wide to be able to do something pretty new and unique off of that drop. But here we got another angle coming up. Look at his front tire, Todd. Oh man, and that's pretty far down from right there too. I'm hoping he's all right.
So Brandon Semenuk completely off course as he makes that right-hand turn. Unfortunately for him, he's gonna get scored on that, an 11.20. So for Semenuk, Cam, it all comes down to run two.
Well, it's crazy. He knows what it takes to win. You need to bring something brand new. That's the way he has learned to win slopestyle here, and that's the poker game that he plays. But in order to do that, obviously, you got to put a lot of chips on the table, and that means risk. Right there, bit him.
So we move back to the start gate, and this is Thomas Janone, the young man out of Belgium, just 23 years of age. The mark to beat still remains that, the 93 put up by Brett Rheeder.
We call this guy the king of consistency, but on a day like today where so many consistent riders are messing up, can Thomas Janone do what it takes to put together a top to bottom? 360 bar spin off the top drop, and that smooth style we come to associate with him. There it is, a 360 bar spin to flat table, an opposite 450 on the hip, so being very well-rounded with his trick choices as well. A backflip bar spin, a tuck no-hander, not huge extension, but holding it together with a huge trick, a cork 720 on the second jump of the four-pack. 360 tuck no-hander, one of his favorite moves. Wow! Wagering a lot up into the Joyride cabin with that double tail up and a 360 invert down. Now into the cannon. Oh, a relatively new trick for Thomas Janone. The backflip off the cannon. All right, well, consistent so far. A tail whip up. Ooh, a 360 tuck no-hander down, taking a trick you would see in BMX street and applying it to mountain bike slopestyle.
So the 2012 Joyride champion is complete on run number one, a big sigh of relief for last year's FMB overall champion. But the question, Cam, did he do enough to unseat that man and the 93?
Well, this run was definitely a work of art. I love watching Janone ride in slow motion because you get to really appreciate his style. Right there in that quirk 720, just eyeing up his landing so much earlier than a lot of the other riders in the field. And this double tail up, that's very risky. If you slip a pedal when you land into that step up, you're gonna come flying out of that step down without any control. But control is the name of the game for Thomas Janone. And right here, probably one of the best parts of the run, the 360 tuck no hander off the drop. He puts the bars in his lap. Very unique.
And the score comes down as an 86.80 for Thomas Janone of Belgium. He moves into second place. An impressive work by Tommy G, but up next is someone else who never ceases to impress. We've got American Nikolai Rogatkin. When we return to Joyride at Crankworks Whistler, this is the Red Bull Signature Series. Welcome back to the Red Bull Signature Series. This is Joyride at Crankworks from beautiful Whistler, British Columbia. And we've got American Nikolai Rogatkin up next. But first, let's take a look at what we missed while we were away. The other half of the new Swedish contingent, Max Fredriksson, the 23-year-old.
Well, yet again, another rider coming out swinging out of Sweden. If Martin Soderstrom is the game saw conquered, and Emilia Hansen's new kid on the block, well, Max Fredriksson is right there in the middle, ready to peak. 360 bar spin off the big drop, really getting off to a great start. And then wagering a lot right here with the double tail whip. and his foot slipped off just a tiny bit, but you need so much precision to have enough speed for that cannon right there. Not able to hold the speed together. It's gonna be all about run number two for Max Fredrickson.
So Fredericks is saddled with that 39.20, but in our two-run format, he can throw that away on his second run, as you are looking at 20-year-old Nikolai Rogatkin out of Lincoln, Mass, set to drop in here on the other side of North America. And look at the crowd that's turned out to watch this young man, because he always, and I mean always, Cam, puts on a show.
Well, this guy, look at that. Exactly what you said, putting on a show. That was very unique right there. The caveman, kind of like a skateboard acid drop, jumping off with his feet and putting the bike underneath him. This guy has been standing on so many podiums so far this year. This is a really long course. I'm curious to see if he's got a new trick for every feature. There we go, that Cork 720. Oh, man. Coming up so short, he was about a bike length too short on that. As we said before, that lip is so incredibly steep. You have to come into it so quick. Let's look back at how he started this run very uniquely. Hopped off his bike, jumped off of that small drop. So it's cool seeing a small feature on the course because people are able to get creative. Then that fast plant 360, we've been seeing him throw that into runs all season. But right here, you can kind of already tell based on his body language, he's on a little bit different axis than he has been throughout the beginning part of the season. Very short. He actually put his face right into the ground there. So hopefully he's all right and we can get him back up for run two.
Second place last year, looking for his first victory at Joyride. And Nikolai Rogatkin doing some minor maintenance there on the bike, which took the brunt when he came up short. The fans here are just happy to see him up and moving around. As we take a look at our leaderboard, after one run, it is Brett Rheeder setting the standard with that 93. Thomas Janone in second, and Emil Johansson sitting in third with the 85.20.
Well, things are going to get really interesting here now, Todd, because as you noted at the beginning of the show, for run number two, we take the lowest score, drop them first, and so the leader goes last. So who's the lowest score at this point? None other than the king of Joyride, Brandon Semenuk.
And he's making sure that all the excess dirt and dust on that rail where he went down in run number one is cleaned off. So the defending champion set to drop in as we start run number two. Semenuk currently sitting at 11.20, but remember, two runs, we only keep the best score.
Well, you can feel the energy right now. Look at Ryan Nyquist eating an apple. Apparently, an apple keeps the doctor away, but also keeps you riding slow style at 37 years old. Tricks of the trade. But yeah, everybody here is so excited to see what the king of Joyride has up his sleeve. He always brings secret moves. Right now, he only made it two features into his first run, so this is going to be a doozy.
Mark to beat is a 93 put up by Canada's Brett Rheeder.
So there's that new one again, that fast plant 360 one-footed X up. Always one to think outside the box, Brandon Semenuk. So I have an idea what we might see here. A 180 to half cab off the huge drop. A new move for slopestyle mountain biking. Right into the backflip tail up. Coming up a little bit short and slipping a pedal. Straighter in the next jump. Oh, don't tell me he's waving this one off. Oh, he is. He's not going to continue this run.
So two straight airs from Brandon Semenuk, signaling his intention of, he's just not feeling it, or did he lose scrub enough speed at the top where he just doesn't have it?
Man, we're talking about Brandon Semenuk. He's always checkers or wreckers, first or last. You know, he had a run in mind that could win the contest, and missing one trick, he's not going to be satisfied with that. So instead of just trying to salvage, it looks like he's throwing this one away, and he's going to have to wait until next year to try to get that fifth Joyride title.
So there'll be a new champion in 2016 at Joyride at Crankworks, as the defending champion has pretty much waved the white flag.
It's such a shame we're not going to see the master at work here, but we get to see a glimmer of genius. Look at the brilliance of that 180 to half cab off. I have a feeling that backwards takeoffs is really going to kind of be something that represents the future of slopestyle, and we saw it here first, 2016 Joyride by Brandon Semenuk.
And there you saw the slip pedal. The score comes in as a 33.40. Does him no good, but he's standing by with Tina.
Yeah, well, I think everyone down here, including yourself, Brandon, wanted to see you complete that run. You had that switch 180, I mean, groundbreaking right there, and then stopped halfway down your run. What happened there?
I just had some headwind right going into the jump, and I kind of knew I wasn't going to get the right distance, and he's gonna be just tagged a little bit, blew a foot. So, I mean, that's not going to cut it.
Yeah, and you're one to go all out or nothing. But, Brandon, you've won this event four times. You have a ton of fans here. To just be out here and do a new groundbreaking trick like that, what does that mean?
I mean, it's cool, but it would have been the icing on the cake of a good run. No, it's just kind of... It's not much to me without a complete run.
Well, that's why you've won so many times here, Brandon. Thanks for your time.
Thanks, Tina. Tough break for the defending champion, Brandon Semenuk, and his dream of the fifth victory goes by the wayside, at least for this year. Much more relaxed, Brett Rheeder remains on top of the leaderboard. Will he be able to hold on to that top spot? We'll find out when we return to Joyride at Crankworks Whistler. You're watching the Red Bull Signature Series. Welcome back to the Red Bull Signature Series. This is Joyride at Crankworks Whistler. And you can feel the tension in the air here as we are getting into our final riders. Todd Harris alongside Cam McCall. Cloudy skies, but that will not stop this man. 26-year-old Logan Pete from Canada. Now remember, he picked up a 20.40 on run number one on the crash, but that all goes away in our two-run best run count format.
Yeah, a surprising little dose of tough luck for Logan Pete in his run one. He's training partners with Brandon Semenuk, and he has that precision that we come to associate with people from that riding group. So right now, one last chance to get a score in the bag here at Joyride. Nice backflip, bar spin to tuck no hander, and then opting for just the tuck no hander where he messed up the tail up in run number one. And a smooth backflip tail up on the first jump of the four pack, right into a bar spin to tail whip. Huge combo, really going for it here. Logan Pete with a 450 bar spin on the hip. Just enough time to catch his breath, but now it's back to business with the Joyride cabin. An opposite 360 down. So much difficulty spinning off a high consequence obstacle like that, your opposite way, and a flip on the cannon. That's a new move for Logan this season.
Here he is, final feature, Cam.
Hold it together, Logan. 360 down. There we go. That's the type of riding we expect to see out of Logan P.
The big question, though, is it enough to knock off fellow countryman Brett Rheeder and the 93?
Well, yeah, Brett Rheeder dodged a bullet with Brandon Semenuk, who represents the biggest hurdle between Brett and his first Joyride title. But right here, a guy who also hails originally from Ontario trying to take his old riding buddy out. Logan Pete doing what he needed to do to get his second run in the bag after messing up his first run. Will it be enough to unseat Brett Rheeder, though? I'm not sure. Brett's run was flawless.
Looking for a 93 or better, and Logan Pete's score coming in now is an 83, so his day is done. Currently, Logan Pete sitting on the 83, and now we can watch the rest of the field and find out exactly where he finishes in 2016 as we go back to the top of the course. 37-year-old rookie at Joyride, Ryan Nyquist, out of Santa Cruz, California, set to drop in. First run score, remember, he had the blowout on the back tire, only picked up a 34.
I want so badly to see him stomp this run. He worked so hard to adapt all of his BMX tricks to the mountain bike, and now he's here in familiar territory where he won BMX contests about 10 years ago. But now on the bigger bike, bigger features, three in that drop, going to the moon on that steep jump of the backflip bar spin. He's going for the 720 again, even smoother this time, about a 760 on that hip. Backflip one-handed X up. I love how he's been linking it. There it is, right into that 360 one-handed X up. And then focus right here. He's been spinning to the left. Now he's spinning to the right. An opposite 360 suicide no-hander, putting that front brake to use. A backflip bar spin up and a backflip down. So he opted out of that double truck driver that caused his run to come to a screeching halt in run number one. Unique trick on the cannon, a nothing. He's almost made it, Todd. A truck driver up, one last feature, the biggest drop on the course, a 360.
Yeah.
Wow, now that is not something that you're gonna be comfortable doing if you spent your life on a BMX bike. That is a huge drop, and Ryan Nyquist spinning it like a champ. Well, let's take a look back. Here's the originality right there, putting his feet on the pegs, taking the hands off. That's called a rocket suicide no-hander. Then look at that 720. It took him over a year and a half to figure out how to spin that larger bike two rotations. And then here's some Ryan Nyquist favorites. Backflip one-handed X up, right into the 360 one-handed X up, having a well-rounded run. The 360 up, and I know right here he's going, all right, here it goes, all or nothing. He's been sweating that 360 drop. So excited to see him pull that off.
And Nyquist, two runs complete. His day is done. What will be the score? It's a 78.20 for 37-year-old Ryan Nyquist. A tremendous performance by him, and he's standing by with Tina.
Yes, and Ryan, you had to fight your way to this event to have just done what you did. How was the payoff?
Man, that was everything. It's crazy to do a run and then like get a flat tire and have to like regroup and then do a second run, but like honestly, I was just like sweating that drop so hard and just knowing that I had to do something and 360 was gonna be it. And I'm just so glad it worked because it was honestly for me, like that's the biggest thing I've ever done. Like, and the scariest thing for sure. And just when you trust yourself and you trust your skills and then you just go for it and it pays off, man. That feeling is what I live for.
Well, and this whole crowd just erupted in cheers, guys.
Oh man, it just gives you a warm feeling in your tummy seeing Ryan Nyquist embracing mountain biking and stomping his run. This crowd went nuts.
Nyquist, absolute legend status at 37, trying out a new sport. Right now, let's send it back to Sal Masekela in the studio.
Thank you, Todd Harris. How many of you at home think that Brett Rheeder can finally get the monkey off his back and get the win? Or could Max Fredrickson, Nikolai Rogatkin, Anthony Messer, maybe Thomas Janon, all of whom are ripping, could they catch him? How about Ryan Nyquist and his statement here today? BMX legend comes to the mountain bike crowd and rips it. That plus 10 days of celebrating mountain bike culture here at Crankworx Whistler. There is plenty to talk about, so get involved in our conversation. Follow the Red Bull Signature Series on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, any way you get down socially. The hashtag is Red Bull Joyride, or you can go to RedBullSignatureSeries.com, where we have even more exclusive content for you about this event and our upcoming events all year. Plus, you can also download the Red Bull TV app to watch this show and catch up on every episode from all seasons. Why? Because we love you. You're watching Joyride at Crankworx Whistler, part of the Red Bull Signature Series.
Welcome back to the Red Bull Signature Series. And there is the current leader, Brett Rheeder, enjoying his 7-point lead over the rest of the competitors. But we'll see if any of our next riders can give him a run for that top spot here at Joyride. And this is Max Fredrickson. Had his issues in run number one as the wind is really picking up here in British Columbia. The 23-year-old sitting on a 39.20, trying to top Brett Rheeder's score of 93.
Man, taking a look at those flags waving, you can see his jersey waving. He's being smart right now, trying to choose a moment to drop in when there's not a huge wind gust. But there we go, he messed up his first run, but he's off to a good start now. The nose press 360 off the start drop, a tail whip up. Now Max Fredrickson has been having his best season yet, and it would be great to see him get a top to bottom here. Ooh, up in the ante already from his first run, a 360 double bar spin off the drop. Huge extension on that backflip bar spin to tuck no-hander. And there's a double tail up on the hip. He is 100% going for it.
Carrying a ton of speed, Cam.
Backflip tail up, and like you said, carrying good speed, landing really smooth. A lot of people have been casing that jump, but not Max Fredrickson. A 360 tail up, overspinning on that hip. This could really shake things up.
Onto the whale tail.
A bar spin up, and there's that double tail up down. That's where he messed up the first run, but he's got 2 feet firmly planted on the pedals now. Whoa, a new one for Max Fredrickson. A backflip tuck no-hander on the cannon. Like we said, you do a variation on that, the judges love it. Bar spin to bar spin back, and then a 360 bar spin down. Wow, Max Fredrickson, that's the run of his life.
Making it very difficult for the judges as the 23-year-old Swede, top to bottom, carrying a ton of speed and from our vantage point looked extremely clean.
Oh, that's the name of the game. You know, his riding really reminds me of the guy who's sitting in first place right now, Brett Rheeder. You can tell who some of these athletes really watch and try to use as an example. And Max Fredrickson spinning the same direction as Brett right there with that 360 double bar spin. And then check out the extension on this backflip bar spin to tuck no-hander. Having to grab the rear brake, you see that rear wheel slow down there. Basically hanging on the edge of control the entire run, but throwing in huge tricks like this double tail up on the step down. And this is a new one for him, a backflip tuck no-hander on that cannon feature. Can't stress enough how difficult it is to flip variation off of a cannon. A bar spin back up, and then this is exactly the way he needed to end this run, a tough combo off a huge drop, the 360 bar spin, and then celebratory high fives in the finish.
Now just waiting for the score to come down for Fredrickson. Remember, he was sitting on a 39.20, and this is much better. 89.90. Fredrickson goes into second place.
Look at the look on his face. He's like, did I just land that, and did I actually just go into second place? Definitely a career highlight right there for Max.
What an amazing run by the rookie from Sweden. He bumps the 2012 champion, Tomas Janone, down to third. But the list of riders still to come, nothing short of impressive. When we come back, American Nikolai Rogatkin will have his run. When we come back to Joyride at Crankworks Whistler, this is the Red Bull Signature Series. Welcome back to the Red Bull Signature Series. This is Joyride at Crankworks Whistler. The weather seems to be just holding off here for our final competitors. Next up, a competitor who could seriously upset the leaderboard. Last year's second place finisher, American Nikolai Rogatkin.
Everybody's been talking about Nikolai this week leading up to the event. Everybody says he's got a new trick for this start feature. So this is the last run to pull it. There it is, that fast plant 360 tail whip. That's a new one for slopestyle mountain biking. I feel like we have so many never been done moves already so far. Now Nikolai really needs to start holding things together. He didn't make it past this step up last run. Let's see if he can get that Cork 720. He's trying it again. Oh, he comes up short again. Blowing out both tires this time. Well, he looks to be all right, but man, is he ever just devastated. Nikolai wants to win this event so bad, and he knows he needs to bring something new and unexpected, so he did exactly that with that fast plant 360 tail up. A never been done maneuver for slopestyle mountain biking, but you know he's thinking about that Cork 720 that brought his run to a halt in run one, and he had the same exact, almost mirror image mistake from run one right here, just coming up a bike length too short, blowing out both tires. And right now, he's probably experiencing a little bit of pain, but more devastation than anything.
So for the man that finished in second place last year, it is back-to-back DNFs for 20-year-old Nikolai Rogatkin. Well, the crowd's sensing something great possibly going to happen here, and this man may be the one to do it. Anthony Missouri, 20 years of age, out of Canada, dropping in now on his second and final run of the day. Run one score pretty solid at 81.60.
Well, you can feel that, right, Todd, when the crowd is really excited to see somebody drop in. This is their Vancouver boy right here, the guy who burst onto the scene in 2011. Going so high. This is exactly what everybody expects out of Anthony Missouri. Way high off the lip with that flat spin 360 tabletop. And he's grown into a very consistent competitor now too, landing very smooth on that backflip tail up and adding a no-hander into the front flip now. So he's going for it right here. He wants to knock Brett Rheeder off the top step of that podium. Already improving on his first run, 360 into the Joyride cabin, getting a straight backflip down. Now he had a backflip bar spin in run one, so messing up a little bit. But if he can improve something here on the final feature, then he might have a chance. A backflip up, one last chance for a trick. A 360 down this time.
Oh!
Just a little bit off axis on that hop 360, landed on the rear wheel. The front wheel never actually even touched the ground. So look at this, in run number one, he had the backflip tail, but he cased, and so he lost speed. In run number two here, he landed perfect, so he was able to get that front flip tuck no-hander variation instead of just the straight front flip that he did in run number one. A double tail up on the hip. Judges love it when the entire time you're in the air, you're just doing a trick. That double tail definitely takes up all the time. But here's where things went wrong. See that? Landing on the rear wheel, front wheel never touches the ground. Luckily, he slid out on his backside, but that's not going to be good for his score.
He needed one more clean landing for that full pole. He was sitting on 81.60 on run number one, and run number two, it's not going to help his cause. Well, we're down to our final competitors. Will Brett Rheeder finally be able to stand on top of the one podium that has eluded him? Or will 2012 winner Tomas Janone step up for his second victory? We'll find out when we return to Joyride at Crankworks Whistler. You're watching the Red Bull Signature Series. There is the current leader, Brett Rheeder, who's never been closer to taking the first place spot here at Joyride. While he waits to see if he'll need to take his final run, let's have a look at what happened while we were away. Emil Johansson, the 17-year-old sensation who came out on his first run and laid down an 85.20.
Realistically, Todd, he's already done exactly what he came here to do. Nobody expects somebody to have this great of an appearance of their first joyride, but he had more in the tank and he decided to go for it run number two with that backflip double tail up. But landing long, losing speed, and tagging that jump, he knew he wasn't going to be able to beat that amazing run he had his first go. So he kind of just did it for the fans, which is great to see a young rider really understanding that he's also there to put on a great show. So celebrating down there in the podium area because he's already got a great finish locked up.
The Swedish contingent celebrating with Emil Johansson. He gets to keep that run one score of 85.20. Here we are as Thomas Janone gets set for his final run, the last man that can unseat your leader. And will it be Janone or will it be Rheeder? Remember, the mark he has to beat is a 93.
Well, Janone represents a huge bullet for Brett Rheeder to dodge right now. So you know that Brett is definitely gritting his teeth right now, because if anybody has what it takes right here, Thomas Janone, with his consistency and deep bag of tricks, added with style, has what it takes. Coming into that really steep step-up jump, getting the style on that 360 bar spin to table. And then an opposite 360 one-footed table. So much style, you would never know that's his opposite direction. A backflip bar spin to tuck no hander, more extension this time than last. Getting that cork 720, tagging a little bit, but holding it together, getting that 360 tuck no hander. He's on a good one. Is he gonna go for that double whip again? He does, lands it smooth into the whale tail. Oh, more extension this time on that click 360 table. What's he got on the cannon? A backflip tuck no hander, huge flip combo on the cannon. Oh, he looks calm, cool, collected. Two more tricks left. An opposite tail up, and a 360 tuck no hander down. Huge extension on that tuck no hander.
So the big question is, did he do enough to surpass Reader's 93? He needs a 93.01 to take the lead.
It's so cool. When you watch these riders do their first run and it looks spotless, you would never know they have so much left in the chamber. So to watch Thomas Janone ride right now is basically like watching an artist paint. Look at this 360 one-footed table, is opposite direction. The bike's completely flat. His foot's way off the side of the bike. Bigger extension this time on the back foot bar spin to tuck no hander. And this is one of the parts of the run that I know got him that great score on run one. Double tail up into the whale tail. A lot on the line when you try to do that on the step up, because you want to have your speed for the step down. And then here it is, getting good variety with the opposite tail up. And then remember his extension on this 360 tuck no hander in run one? It didn't look like that. That's a big improvement on that score right there. I can't wait to see what the judges do with it.
It is going to be very tight. He needs a 93.01 or better to take the lead away from Brett Rheeder and force Rheeder into a last run to win the competition.
Rheeder just wondering, am I going to have to try to beat my own run here?
And it's good, but not good enough. Thomas Janone, a 91.20, puts him in second place, which means Brett Rheeder picks up his first win at Red Bull Joyride.
Oh, man, I'm so happy for this kid right now. I remember when he first burst onto the scene, he's such a good kid, and you could tell he had the work ethic to make it happen. But so many things have to line up and come together to win a contest like this. He's won pretty much every other slopestyle event out there, but this is the Super Bowl. It's the one that means the most, and this has been his life goal right now. He's realized his dreams. Now he gets to just put on a show for the fans.
A cruise run down to the bottom of the course. Remember, 14 features on this year's course, and it was so tight, and the guys that were able to accomplish what they wanted to on this course really had to keep their system on lock.
Exactly, like you said, 14 features. The sport has completely changed since its inception 13 years ago. And to be able to put together a winning run, not only do you have to bring in new maneuvers that are secret, but you have to basically carefully craft your run to where you don't have repeats. So when we saw him come off this cannon log feature that you're seeing him ride right now in run one, wow, he does a backflip bar spin there. He did a backflip tail whip on it in his first run, and it was complementary to that backflip bar spin to opposite tail up top. So a lot of thought goes into these runs, and right now a lot of celebration is going to be happening down at that finish corral for Brett Rheeder.
Brett Rheeder picking up his first victory at Red Bull Joyride. And it all came from the first run for him of two. Rheeder's 93 stands up with a lot of talent behind him. Thomas Junon gets second, Max Fredriksson third, then Emil Johansson, Logan Pete, and Anthony Missouri rounding out your top six. What a performance. He's now standing by with Tina Dixon.
Well, Brett, you've had a fourth, you've had a second, and you've had a 16th here in Whistler, but today it was your day. How would you describe this moment knowing you just won Red Bull Joyride?
I don't know, lost for words once again. This has been a tough one over the years. Not like the other contests. You know, it's steep and there's lots of features and lots of crowd and pressure and I feel amazing.
This year, without the pressure of the triple crown, were you able to just really focus on your own line and just tune everyone out?
Yeah, I was. Like, I still had some like self-conflicting pressure, but I mean, I didn't have that triple crown, and you know, hearing the media talk about it and all that. So this year was just on myself, and I just dropped in and did my thing, and it ended up working out.
It ended up working out, and not only did you win this event, but you are the overall Crankwork Slopestyle champion with your result from Rotorua. So just some icing on the cake.
Oh my God, that's so amazing. We're missing Kelly out here, Stevie Smith. I gotta say, it's not the same without them here. I wanna say thanks to the Joyride crew too for making a beautiful course. And thanks.
Well, you put together a beautiful run. Congratulations, Brett. Yeah. Guys.
Thank you very much, Tina. It is now time for the Red Bull signature moment. Last year, Rheeder seemed destined to capture the first ever triple crown and stand atop the elusive Joyride podium. But his internal demons had other plans. Today, the mental game proved so tough for the entire field, nearly half the runs went uncompleted. Brett proved that to be a true champion, you have to not only defeat the course and all the other world-class competitors, but manage internal pressure in order to win the day. Brett now stands alone on the one podium that has eluded him his entire career. Congratulations, Brett Rheeder, for becoming the 2016 Joyride champion and for receiving the Red Bull signature moment. Well, Cam, what can you say? A well-deserved victory for Brett Rheeder.
So happy to see him stomp that, and once again, Red Bull Joyride never disappoints. We've turned a new chapter in the sport, and it's very fitting because this very hill is where the sport began 13 years ago. Now, what will be the impact of this year? I have a feeling we'll look back at this year and we'll say this is the first time that Brett Rheeder won Red Bull Joyride, because some tells me it may not be the last time we see him on the top step of that podium.
That'll do it for us. For now, we send it back to Sal Masekela.
Thanks, Todd. The levels of this sport continue to blow our minds. And thanks to you guys for joining us here at Joyride at Crankworx Whistler in beautiful British Columbia, Canada. Congratulations to Canadian Brett Rheeder, finally getting that top spot of the podium that has been eluding him for years. But that's what happens when you work hard. Also, congrats to Thomas Junon and to the rookie, the young Swede Max Fredriksson, making his podium debut at his first ever Joyride. Once again, thanks for coming to the party. On behalf of the entire NBC Sports crew, including Todd Harris, Cam McCall, Tina Dixon, and yours truly, we will see you next time.